this for 2 weeks, and we'll see how it works out. She was interviewing me when I was interviewing the director. But it's like, I'm sitting there going, okay, whatever. You know, I was just grateful to have somebody that would say yes, and that I wasn't sure I could afford. Can we ever afford financially to do the things that we think we should step out in faith to do? But I made a pledge with myself that, you know, all the money that I would earn was already accounted for. I mean, I could tell you every dollar was already spent before I earned it. That should have never happened to you, but I kept thinking, if I hired help, where was this money going to come from? And I had to make a real commitment to myself about my reorder business. You know, when you get more busier recruiting people and developing offsprings, I think something suffers. And so just sitting around at home on the phone calling customers suffered. And I thought, well, if I'm going to have all this great help, I'm going to have more time. And I made a commitment for, you know, at least 3 hours a week, hour and a half daytime hours, hour and a half evening hours, to reach all my customers, you know, a certain block every single week, that I could write her a paycheck on reorder business alone. But if I could just find the money was always there, but if I could find new money that I really wasn't bringing home easily, that would pay her paycheck. She was a single parent. Wasn't a matter of me saying, oh, could I pay you twice next week? No, she needed her money on Friday no matter what, and I knew that. It had to be a pledge and a commitment. Anything worth having has to have a serious pledge attached to it, or else she'll waffle. Couldn't ask my husband to back me up on it because, A, he wouldn't have approved of it in the first place. B, he didn't have any more money than I did, and every dollar that we earned was out the door. So it was like I had to keep that commitment. And bless her heart, it worked. And then I had a tax accountant in my life that said, well, you know, if you're going to have an employee, we have to be withholding and all that. She didn't like that part. She was from another country, so she was doing just fine before I came into her life. But now we made her legitimate. And we were going to have withholding, and she was going to get Social Security, and we were going to have all these wonderful things in her life that really were an aggravation for her when I approached it. But it proved to be the best thing all the way around. Gave me legitimacy in writing her off as an employee and all that stuff. Had her in my employ for 15 and a half years. She practically raised my children. She certainly managed my house. She never drove until one day I said, Bernadette, I can't keep doing all this. You're going to have to drive. I gave her lessons, bought her a car. She was able to maintain her own little lifestyle with her own children. And then when she knew that we were going to leave the New England area and move on, we had to work to find her another family, but we left her with a large severance that paid to send her son to law school.
Wow.
So when people come into your life, it's not just for today or for tomorrow, it's for, in theory, a lifetime. If you take care of enough people, they will all take care of you, and that's each one in their own place. Parents had a big role in my life. She certainly had a big role. And what does that do? It freed me up to do the things that I love the most, which was, as many of you have spoken clearly about it today, building up enough people and helping them get out of life more than what they ever dreamed they could, and that you would be paid proportionally in the process. People ask me a lot about, you know, what was your driving. Truthfully, I got into this thing, it was to make money. When I left it, it was still to make money. I mean, money was the driving force, because you never have enough money. I have 4 children now, 6 grandchildren, but all along the way, their needs was my driving factor. We wanted certainly a comfortable lifestyle after the fact, and I feel good that we have that. I don't regret any of my working years. Other than the fact that they made me retire. And people say, you know, it was only a regret from the standpoint that there was going to be another market. I would have attacked another market. That's just who I was. And then someone asked me, what was the most important word to you in your opinion? The word's opportunity. If an opportunity was when something is put on the table that you have a chance to have a piece of, you don't even think twice about it. If I always said, if the company had researched it, if they believed that they were going to be big there, why shouldn't I go and get my part of it? So when I started in Mary Kay, it was the United States and the United States, and that was it. And I built my corner up in the northeast corner of the country. And I used to sit around and think, God, how do people ever get all the way out to California? I couldn't even get a recruit back in Texas, which was my original home. I used to think, it was just, how do people just do that? And then all of a sudden, one thing happens, and then you get a lead somewhere else. And the next thing you know, you're kind of dribbling down the East Coast. The next thing you know, you're out in the Midwest. And it's a recruit here that becomes a director there and all that kind of thing. And before you know it, you have an organization. And so my first opportunity came along. I was only I was a consultant for 18 months. I was a director for 5 years to the day. And I was a national for the rest of my life. Mm-hmm. When I debuted as a director, my senior, not my direct director, but my senior, her senior, became a very influential part of my life. And the day I debuted, she said, Annie, get your eyes on national. That's the place to be. Well, it was easy for her to say. She was the first national in the company, one of two.